was held in Dublin, in Ireland, last week. Right? That was from August 21 to 26. And the theme was the gospel of family, joy for the world. The theme was based on Pope Francis' own work entitled On Love in the Family. God is the author of this love in the family. God puts this love in the family. And God provides means to preserve and increase this love. We call these means God's commandments. Today's readings help us to reflect on the relationship between love and commandments. In the first reading, Moses repeatedly urged the Israelites to observe the commandments of the Lord. So our recollection tells us that the commandments were given by God to Moses after the Exodus, that is, after the Israelites were liberated from slavery in Egypt. So the story of deliverance does not only communicate the might and power of God, more so, it demonstrates God's fatherly love towards Israel. We may call it God's fatherly love because God considered Israel his firstborn son. This being the case, we can say that at the heart of the Exodus, that is, we find the father-son story. God exercised his fatherhood to liberate his firstborn son, Israel. So the commandments then were founded on this father-firstborn-son relationship. They were on one hand expression of God's fatherly love, and on the other hand, they were guidelines for the firstborn-son Israel on how to respond to this love and how to be loyal to this father-son relationship. So the commandments protect the love in the father-firstborn-son relationship. It protects the love God placed in every human heart. It protects the love in the individual. It protects the love in the family. It protects the love a person has for God, and eventually in his name. Love and commandments. Let us go back to the first reading. According to Moses, the observance of the commandments brings two things. The people will live and obtain wisdom and intelligence. First, the commands of the Lord are life-giving. They give life, they animate lives. The responsorial psalm echoes this truth as it says, the one who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord. Second, the commands of the Lord teaches one to view and approach life according to the fatherly love and the desires of the heart of God. That means we see life, we approach life from how God wants it to be. Love and commandment. During the time of Jesus, as we have heard in today's gospel, the Pharisees and the scribes were fixated on human precepts to the point that God's commands were overlooked. Human traditions displaced the commandments. That was why Jesus candidly said, you disregard God's commandment but claim human tradition. Practices of external purification like cleaning the hands, cups, kettles, beds, etc. were given so much emphasis. But the cleansing of the internal inside of that person. But the things that come out from within are what? The five. Can you say it again? Second reading, that was a few decades after the resurrection. James encouraged the first Christians to be doers of the word and not hearers. by God's presence. Now, let me end this sharing by going back to the theme that I mentioned earlier, the gospel of the family joy for the world. Somebody said that this the theme conveys three things, as you can see that. The family is part of God's plan from the beginning. The family is the first school of faith and love, because it's in the family where we first come to know Jesus. It is also in the family where we experience this love from parents, that we love from God, and we learn what to love from the family. So the family is a school of faith and love. Lastly, the family is a living testimony of God's life and love in the world. Well-known speakers reflected on these matters last week, along with married couples and some young people. I watched actually some of them. Yeah. I was not there, that's why I was on YouTube later on. However, in August 25, the theme was not just in my mind. The theme was the gospel of the family joy. It became a reality in front of me when I entered the chapel and saw the family in prayer. Yes, the family composed of parents and children as part of God's plan. You can see from there, the father in front with a child, and then one child, and then the mother. So the parents, I assume that out of love, they were teaching their very young children the foundational commandment, the first commandment. Know and kneel before the Lord. They were not saying, "Oh, my child, come, sit or kneel." They just knelt. And the children followed. Diba, in the Philippines, may kasabihan tayo, kung anong ginagawa ng